Hello and welcome to Topic TV. My name is Joseph Shaw and today I'll be looking at global warming. Joining me is Professor Christopher Phillips. Hello, Christopher.
Hello, Joseph.
And thanks for joining us.
You're welcome.
Now, in recent years, there's been a lot of talk surrounding global warming, but people are still unsure to exactly what global warming is. So, Christopher, what exactly is global warming?
Well, global warming basically refers to a gradual increase in temperature of the Earth's atmosphere caused by the vast inflation of greenhouse gases.
Oh, so these gases include CO2 and methane?
Yes, amongst others. Correct. This increase in gases is the cause of a process called the greenhouse effect. Now, the greenhouse effect is when the sun's heat and light is trapped within the Earth's atmosphere, causing it to rise in temperature. For instance, this effect works very similar to a car on a hot sunny day.
Oh, so the heat gets trapped inside the car and therefore increases the temperature.
Exactly, Joseph.
It cannot escape out of the car.
Exactly. It's absorbed through the car's windscreen and it's therefore, as you quite rightly say, it's trapped inside the vehicle, causing the temperature to rise.
Well, thank you for that, Christopher. Now, earlier on, we went out for ourselves to investigate the effects of global warming and exactly how it can be reduced, as now we can see from this short report.
For 2.5 million years, the Earth's climate has dramatically changed, cycling from ice ages to warm periods. But in the last century, the planet's temperature has risen unusually fast, from about 1.2 to 1.4 degrees Fahrenheit. Scientists believe it is human activity driving the temperatures up. This process is known as global warming.
We teamed up with senior environmental specialist Liam Barber to see what exactly are the effects of global warming and ways it can be reduced.
Hi, I'm an environmental specialist. Now, as mentioned earlier, carbon dioxide and methane are two of the largest gases that contribute to global warming. Now, carbon dioxide includes the burning of fossil fuels or the release of emissions from cars. And a recent statistic has showed us that there's been a 37% increase in the traffic on the UK's roads. So that's a lot more emissions damaging our environment. Now, we can cut our CO2 footprint from transport by taking public transport or even walking or cycling. Now, another contributor is the contribution of methane. Now, this comes from livestock, so if we eat less meat, then we'll reduce the amount of methane being emitted from the food chain. Anyway, on to the house. First of all, the kitchen. You should always turn the washing machine down, save a huge amount of money and energy. Only use the dishwasher when it's full. There's no point doing two runs for the same amount of dishes when you can do one. Turn the cooker down when it's cooking food. You'll save a lot of energy on heating the food. All houses should have single glazing replaced with double glazing. Always eat fresh food or frozen. It takes more energy to keep it frozen. And of course, the big one, recycle. Hello and welcome to Topic TV's day two of the Global Warming Report. Today we're going to be looking at the upstairs rooms of a household and we're going to start with the bedroom. Now, in many modern households, the bedroom often has a TV in it. Now, these TVs will also usually have some form of eco mode considering the environmental drive of the last few years. So, for instance, this TV has something called an eco solution. And if you go onto that eco solution, it will give you a list of settings so you can choose your own specifications for the amount of energy you want to save. Now, I really advise you use these settings because they're an excellent way of saving energy. Now, also in bedrooms, people often have some form of game console, like, for instance, the PS3 is here. Now, the thing with these games consoles is you must not leave them on standby. By leaving them on standby, you are wasting a huge amount of electricity when you're not using them. Always turn them off if you have the time. Now, also in people's bedrooms, people like to do some work now and then. So you'll often find a laptop or some form of computer. Now, the key thing with laptops is you need to actually turn it off, like the games consoles, when you're not using them. This laptop, for instance, will be wasting a huge amount of energy if I just shut it. instead of actually manually turning it off. There's some simple ways to save energy in your bedroom. Now onto the bathroom. Now you find us in the bathroom. Now many people when washing their teeth will often leave the tap running. You're wasting lots of unnecessary water when you could simply turn it off when you're washing your teeth. The only other thing I can think of for the bathroom is, instead of having a bath, take a shower instead. Save a lot of more water, a lot of energy, and even quite a bit of money too. That's it for the bathroom. Other ways of saving energy around the household include changing all your normal light bulbs to energy-saving light bulbs. These light bulbs are specifically designed to save a lot of energy, and they should be fitted all around the home. Now, these light sockets, for instance, won't take these energy-saving light bulbs, but if it is possible, I really do advise you replace your whole household with these type of bulbs. Another thing you should do is turn your thermostat down 2 degrees in the winter and turn it up 2 degrees in the summer. By doing this, you can save almost 2,000 pounds of carbon dioxide. Instead of turning the heating on, have you ever thought of wearing more clothes? Like a jacket, for instance. An excellent way you can save energy in the garden is by using a washing line to dry clothes instead of using a washing machine and a tumble dryer. Another way you can save energy is by planting a tree. The tree will absorb a lot of the carbon dioxide in the air and thus help the environment. You can also even grow your own vegetables. This is a great way of saving energy and feeding.
Now, for the most obvious thing to do, turn off the light switches and plugs when they're not in use.
Now that we've explored ways of reducing greenhouse gas emissions, we decided to ask a few people for their opinions on global warming. Before this report, did you think that greenhouse gases had such a large effect on our environment?
I did not realise that greenhouse gases had such a large effect on our environment.
Overall, do you think that global warming is one of the most important topics today?
Global warming is one of the most important topics of today, but not just for today, but for the future generations to come.
Finally, now that we've shown you some simple ways of reducing your greenhouse gases, will you make a contribution to help prevent global warming?
I already make a contribution by recycling and turning off unnecessary lights. But now I'm a bit more conscious about global warming, I will make a bit more of an effort.
This has been Topic TV's report on global warming. Thanks very much for watching. Back to you in the studio.
Hello and welcome back. We hope this has given you an insight into the effects of global warming and ways it can be reduced. Once again, we say thank you to our professor, Christopher Phillips. Thank you, Christopher.
Thank you for having me on the show.
And be sure to tune into Topic TV next time. Bye for now.